In 2005, I heard rumors about big fish swimming in Cabo Pulmo. I escaped from school to check if these rumors were true. I had never seen a school of jacks bigger than that I saw that day.
Welcome to Wavelengths, where we talk about our planet with experts from Scripps Institution of Oceanography, covering everything from the deep sea to the edge of the atmosphere. I'm Kate Furby, a marine biologist and journalist. I got my PhD here a few years ago, and now I'm back, learning more about what's happening at Scripps. I'm here today with Dr. Octavio Aburto. He's an associate professor at Scripps Oceanography.
So we are rolling?
We are rolling. Can you tell us a little bit about what you do?
Yes, I work here at Scripps and work mainly with marine protected areas, fisheries, and coastal habitats.
Where is most of your research based?
I have been working here in a very tiny town that is called Cabo Pulmo. It's a very small marine reserve, and it's basically the size of Disneyland. Fishermen here decided to stop fishing in 1995. We were able to show that the recovery was amazing. It was like almost 400% in change. And now you can see animals of fish that can grow up to 3 meters in length, and also the presence of sharks, like bull sharks. And that recovery is one of the largest recoveries in no-take marine areas around the world.
That must feel amazing to be part of that.
Yes, amazing.
Can you tell us what a marine protected area is?
Cabo Pulmo is what is called no-take marine reserve. That basically means the 7,000 hectares of the marine national park close to any extractive activities.
All right, so now we're out in La Jolla, and there's an MPA here too, right?
Yes, in 2012, La Jolla decided to put this MPA. It's very tiny, it's only 2 square kilometers compared with other MPAs. It's a small one, but it's fully protected.
Got it. And compared to Cabo Pulmo, it's pretty small too.
Very small, and it covers a different kind of habitats. But the most important thing is that nobody is fishing, and this produces very, very good benefits. If we have more and more of these areas, we can replenish again the oceans.
A lot of times when I'm talking to people about conservation, there's this idea that it's expensive to do conservation, or that there's this like sort of tension between business and conservation. And I know Cabo Pulmo is a great example of when this is not the case. What is happening in Cabo Pulmo in terms of like economics versus conservation?
Cabo Pulmo is a very tiny place. It's generating a lot of money with these healthy ecosystems. In the past, Jacques Cousteau named the Gulf of California the aquarium of the world, but you cannot see anything that Cousteau saw in the majority of the places. But if you go to Cabo Pulmo, you can see these big fish, these sharks, everything that made famous the Gulf of California.
I love that this sleepy little fishing town switched to solar, decided to protect its fishery, and now it's doing better per capita than the big tourist resorts are. We need more Cabo Pulmos.
We need more, thousands of them.